Hi guys, I'll probably remember. Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to my channel, Film of My Channel. Hi, I'm Akanksha. So today we are going to talk about maskne, and maskne is nothing but acne caused due to mask. So it's not only acne prone skin, even people who have really good skin have been dealing with maskne. I've been getting DMs, I think since June, July, since the lockdown started opening and people started going out, everybody started wearing masks, and a lot of people had issues with their skin. So they've been texting me like I never had acne issue, but since I started wearing mask, I've been breaking out really badly and I don't know what to do. Please do a video about it. But at that point, I personally didn't experience maskne because I didn't step out of my house until July. I was at home, I didn't really go anywhere. But August and September, my house renovation started, so I had to start going out and stepping out my work and certain other works. So I started stepping out frequently and I started to wear masks. And I don't know if you guys remember that my skin, like up till July actually, my skin was decent. It was not the best, but it was pretty decent. I was taking care of my post acne pigmentation, etc., and my skin was quite good until July. But August and September, my skin started breaking out so badly. I blamed it on the weather because usually I do break out during the monsoon, but it was really bad. It is really bad. Like once I remove my makeup, you see like a lot of breakouts, a major scarring, etc. So I thought, I don't even know what the reason is. I don't know. I never blamed it on the mask, but later I realized that mask also was one of the factors. And I've been trying different things and doing different things, and I think I have a few things which might help you with maskne because they have been helping me. I've been seeing really good results since I started doing this. It's nothing new, but I started incorporating this a lot in my routine and it started helping me a lot. My breakouts have reduced a lot, touch wood, comparatively from before. So I'll just show you what I've been doing and then you can also decide if you want to do it or not. So why exactly do you get maskne is that I can't explain the whole scientific reason behind it, but it does make a lot of sense to me that why a person might break out, because you constantly breathe out hot air. The hot air is trapped inside the mask. There's a lot of humidity which is created, hot air, you sweat a lot, your pores are getting really congested, you start getting really oily again, since your pores get really congested. So once there's excess sebum and everything in your skin accumulating in one place, and there's such a hot humid condition where usually bacteria and everything breathes really well, so I think it does make sense that a person tends to break out more. And I've been breaking out here, right here, literally this part more, because usually this part is where we breathe out and a lot of air is accumulated. I'm just going to remove my makeup and I'm just going to show you this process also, because it does help overall in the maskne process. Now before getting into removal of makeup, I wore makeup now because I've been shooting some other video and I thought it's the right time to show you how to do this whole routine as well. But if you are going to wear a mask, please avoid wearing makeup. There is no point of wearing makeup. You're just going to worsen your skin a lot more. So your skin is already going to feel very congested when you wear a mask, but if you have makeup, it might worsen the situation a lot more. So anyways, what's the point of wearing makeup? You're not supposed to remove your mask until you come back home. You need to wear it once you start from home, and you're supposed to remove it later. So literally nobody's going to know who you are or see you. I mean, don't get me with I wear makeup for myself. I understand, but in this situation, I think it's better to avoid makeup. I don't know why are people asking me for, tell me transfer proof lipstick for a mask. Why do you want to wear a lipstick under a mask? Literally nobody can see that lipstick. Not even you. You also can't see that lipstick. These fringes are cute until you have to start washing your face or anything. They always come in the way. Now I am going to definitely recommend, even if you're not wearing makeup, on the day you wear a mask and you come back home, I would definitely, even if you're not wearing makeup, ask you to oil cleanse. So there is an explanation for this. I don't think I can explain it really well. I'll definitely put a paragraph here which actually will make more sense than me explaining, but I'm going to give you a gist of it. So basically sebum is oil, right? Our skin has oil glands, and you have oil in the skin. Skin is filled with oil, so our skin has oil in it, and the only way to clean it or cleanse it is with oil, because it does make sense that oil and water don't mix. But so if you really want to cleanse your pores really well or anything, then you can only do it with oil, because oil, only oil, like it mix and it kind of pulls out every junk and dirt. So if in case you're struggling with acne and you don't double cleanse, then definitely try this. One of my favorite oil is this Claire's Gentle Deep Cleansing Oil. I got this from Limis, correct? I can never pronounce it. It'll be here. Super nice, like oil, really gentle, really nice. So I'm just going to go in with the cleansing oil. Really take your time to cleanse your skin. Now I have makeup, so I'm just going to cleanse off the makeup. But if you don't have makeup, then take a minute to nicely massage your face, like for 1 to 2 minutes, and try to pull out all the sebum from your skin. So I'm just going to take like proper 2 pumps of oil, and I'm going to apply it and start breaking down my makeup. I don't know if any of you guys ever had that, but if you double cleanse for a longer time, you start feeling this gritty texture on your skin that sometimes they say is that sebum, that sebum stuff coming out from your skin and leaving your skin nice and clean. I usually do feel that if I cleanse for more than 3-4 minutes, but that I'll make a separate video about that. I don't do that with makeup on. I don't have to have. So yeah, I just took a bath. You can see, like I told you, I've been breaking out so badly, and the scarring has been so bad. So after washing my face, I don't do this every day. Like if you're a person who's going to go out like 6 days a week, you wear a mask every day, then maybe you can do this mask like once every 2 days. Or like I usually do twice in 1 week, or once in 1 week. If I don't go out, then I do once in 1 week. So I use this, I've been using this mask. So this is the Calm and Detox Facial mask. So this is from a brand called Fiducia Botanicals. None of this video is not sponsored by anybody, guys. So it has Dead Sea Mud Clay, Bentonite Clay, Vetiver, Kaolin, Vetiver, Indian Sienna, Zinc, and Spirulina. So I don't know if you guys know, but kaolin clay is really good to cleanse your pores. It deeply cleanses your pores really well. But it even has zinc. Zinc is really good, very anti-inflammatory. So it cleanses your pores really well. So one more thing is, you can even use a salicylic acid mask. So like the ordinary one has a really good one, or like maybe use like a in a cleanser, like salicylic acid cleanser or anything of that sort. So this is a powder mask. I'm going to mix this and wear this. This really actually really helped, to cleanse my skin really well and get rid of a lot of acne, and to prevent and clean my skin a lot. So usually you can just mix water, but I've been mixing all my masks with this rose water from Sadev. Really good, just pure rose water. If you don't have rose water, you can definitely go in with normal water. Just make sure you don't use tap water. Don't be that conjuice also. Just use like normal drinking water and make a nice paste and apply it. So I'm just going to apply a proper layer. You can use a brush, but I'm too lazy to go get a brush now. So I'm just going to use this mask. Now it does, dry your skin down a little bit, because kaolin is a little drying for the skin. It even has that dead sea mud clay, so which are like a little drying. So if you have dry skin, then this might be a little drying. If you have oily skin, then this will be such a boon. It's so good. Just clears out all the congestion in your skin. But even if you have oily skin, but it's really important to hydrate your skin post this. And there's one more step which I'm going to definitely show you. So this is some mask which I've been really liking. Now I forgot to mention one thing, is that when you oil cleanse, it's really important you get rid of that oil very well. If you have dry skin, then you can surely go in with a very gentle cleanser. It doesn't matter, because you have dry skin, it's going to be fine. But if you have oily skin, then make sure you kind of get rid of the oil you use to cleanse your skin. And always make sure you cleanse your skin, even if you're not wearing makeup. And if you're wearing a mask, then do double cleanse. So usually, like in the morning, I use the simple one, or like the Triad Concentrate face powder. So these are very gentle cleansers. So in the morning they're really good, but in the night when I use an oil and if I want to get rid of the oil, they're really gentle to get rid of the oil for my skin. So I use like the organic 6-in-1. It's not like stripping, but it's a very gentle one, but it kind of even removes the oil really well. So I use the organic 6-in-1 face wash, or I even like the Forever Earth willow bark one. These, like, you know, kind of help get rid of that excess oil. So I'll just, you know, keep this on for 10 minutes and I'll rinse, and then I'll show you one of the very, very important step if you're dealing with acne. So I washed off the mask. My face feels so fresh. I don't know, it just really feels, I usually don't feel like that after every mask, but this one I feel like, you know, cleanses your skin really well. So anyway, the next step, so damn important. I always knew the importance of eyes, but I don't know, I never really took it that seriously. But if you don't ice your face, you've got to start icing. Now, ice, if you like use literal ice, it kind of gets really messy, but you can definitely do that if you're somebody who can remember and store ice every night. But for me, I've been using the Jade Roller. I put this in the freezer. Every time after I use, I just put it in the freezer until the next time I need to use. So it's like ice and chill. So I just take it and I roll it. I've been doing this morning and night, religiously morning and night. And every time I come back, like if I go out, I wear my mask for 1-2 hours. I come back and I make sure I am actually cleansing my skin. I don't, you know, that time I'm not particular, like, you know, oh, I just want to cleanse in the morning and night. No, I cleanse in the morning, night, whenever. If I'm going out and coming back and I'm wearing my mask, then I come back and home and I definitely cleanse my skin again, and then I immediately go in with ice and to calm any inflammation or anything which has been taking on my, like, you know, going on inside my skin. Now, usually I just do this after I wash my face, but because we used a mask, I didn't want it, like, you know, to ice my face and then use a mask. So I'm just, like, you know, using it now. It is so damn soothing to use ice on the face. You have no idea, bro. Like, do it. This is the Isle of Skin Jade Roller, but you can, you know, buy anyone. Make sure it's a, like, through Jade Roller. A lot of things are knockoffs, so be, like, you know, careful that you don't buy knockoffs. Jade Roller is supposed to, like, you know, be cooler for a longer time so that you get that very cooling sensation to your skin. Or else you can just buy an ice roller. You can get ice roller for face ice rollers in Amazon. You can buy them, put them in your freezer, remove it, roll on your face and then put them back. So now once I'm done, I'll again put it back until, like, next morning I use it again. Icing has helped my skin so much. I really, like, you know, got in a very bad mood looking at my skin because it got really bad. It is really bad. I don't know, suddenly, out of nowhere, literally, like, within a month, my skin got from good to really, really, you know, this stage. My skin acts really very weirdly. So next one, which really, really helped, I regret so much for stopping, like, using this, for stopping using it, for has stopped you. Basically, this product got over, so I stopped using this. I think that was the first mistake of my life. This is the Ordinary Niacinamide Serum. If you have acne prone skin, any pigmentation, you have to have it. I've tried a lot of niacinamide, but nothing works like this. It's so quick to work, so nice to stop acne. I regret really badly. Maybe if I, you know, didn't stop using this, my acne would not have gotten this bad. But then, you know, nevertheless, the thing is with this, even if you, like, break out, but you keep using the serum every day, the scarring which is left behind is very minimal. But during when I was breaking out, all, like, this thing was happening, the serum got over. I've been using the serum for, like, past 6 months, but mine got over, like, and then there was a lockdown, so I couldn't, you know, get it anywhere. And I was like, you know, let me try something else. I really like the other ones, but I think for my skin, which doesn't stay really good at all, I think this is the one which works really well. Hi guys, I'm editing, but I forgot to mention a point which I wanted to, so I just thought I'll quickly mention that. So if in case you do break out and you have a lot of breakouts, you have, like, that comedones or that pus type of, you know, acne or pimple, which kind of can get messy when you wear a mask, then I would definitely recommend you to start using spot patches when you're wearing a mask, so that sebum and whatever, that pus type of thing, doesn't get all over your face and create more bacteria. So the ones I've been using are from Cosrx. I got this from
aisle of skin, but I really like the Dr. Burma's spot patches as well, because that one has spot patches for treatment and then it has spot patches just like to cover your pimple up in case you just want to hide it from pollution. So those things are very thin and you can't even notice that you're wearing one. So if in case, you know, you want to protect that all that thing from spreading inside the mask, then definitely wear spot patches. And one more thing is the BHA I've been using is from Sugandha. I think it has really been helping. I use this like a serum every alternate day, and recently I got my hands on Paula's. Actually, this just got delivered yesterday. I didn't have this the day I was filming the video, so I didn't show it. I just got this yesterday. I've heard so much about it, so I don't really have an opinion about it, but I've heard so many good reviews. So if you want to try a BHA, then you can try the Sugandha one. It's a very mild one. Then this one is also like the same 2% BHA, if in case you want to try. Just helps you cleanse your pores and keep your skin in check.
I'll just like wrap this up and then complete my skincare. My skin is kind of feeling really dry. I need to do more. But yeah, these are the four things. One is oil cleansing. Even if you wear makeup, don't wear makeup oil. Always try to oil cleanse your skin. If not every day, at least try doing it alternate days so that you just kind of get rid of oil, all the oil in your skin. Now, second is this mask. This mask works so beautifully. So if you have dry skin, one tip which I can give you is that don't let the mask dry completely. Just, you know, maybe sit for like 5 to 7 minutes and then wash it off. Really good one, like properly cleanses your skin. So if you have an option of salicylic acid, then definitely go with that, like maybe once a week with a mask, and then you can use this the other time. Really beautiful one. This one is icing. Icing is a blessing to your skin. Like, I don't think I'll ever stop icing my face again. Every day, morning and night, I've been doing it, and every time I come back home and if I'm wearing a mask, then this is like always staple in my routine. I come back, cleanse my skin with like a cleanser, and then I definitely go in with this ice on my skin. And the last one is niacinamide. Really important to control that sebum in your skin. Sebum levels only like become too much, and that's the reason you start breaking out. So this helps keep it in a check. These are all the things which I'm telling which might help. And of course, there are always different cases. Despite doing many things, your acne is not controlling, please go see, take help, go see a dermatologist. They can definitely help you and give you a medication or whatever it is. And one more thing is, don't wear makeup under your mask if you're breaking out. It's just going to make it worse. So, and by the way, if you're doing like, oh, I don't wear a mask, I don't really, you know, care about this, then you are just dumb, bro. Like, I don't even know what to say. You're supposed to wear a mask, but these are things which can help. So yeah, that's it for the video. I hope it was useful. I really, really hope, because this was a very bad situation. And yeah, make sure you like, share, subscribe to my channel, and comment below if you have any tips for maskne. Might help me, might help other people in the comment section. Like, really, really need that right now. Do subscribe to my channel, and Amrathi series is going on, so hit the notification bell so that you get notified every time I post. I'm going to post for this 9 days. So yeah, that's a fun time, and yeah, bye.